I'm Brittany, this is Eddie, and welcome to Gay Watch, where we watch gay things. Today is Let That Be Your Last Battlefield, one of the episodes that I did not know was attributed to Gene Kuhn. So, haven't watched it in an extremely long time, don't remember anything. That's a very familiar message on this series at this point. But before we get good and synced, I do want to add a little note that I currently have a cough. It is the same damn cough I get every year in the spring because I had asthma when I was a kid, and so any little cough caused by allergies sticks around for like 3 months and sounds like I'm about to die. It's fine if I have to cough at some point during this video. It's okay. It's whatever. I have water. I'm sorry if it blasts out your headphones. I will try to turn away in time, but this is just a disclaimer that I will more than likely have to cough at more than one point, and I apologize. I'm going to try my best to keep it to a minimum. Now we can get synced and hit play. And the countdown for real. 3, 2, 1, play. Shit. We're just starting off just right with the highest stakes possible, all right? Because Scotty's always on his shit. Well, yeah. I think the string operators on the little shuttlecraft thing were having a time. Yeah, I mean, on one hand, leave no man behind, but on the other hand, we're not entirely sure it's a man. It's just humanoid. I mean, I guess we're boldly going. You know, I do kind of miss the era where they would use miniatures for stuff like this. Because, like, they actually got pretty good in, like, the 90s. Using that to represent much bigger things. And then CG came along. I have no clue who the fuck is on this shuttlecraft. I remember nothing. Get out of town! This one! Of course this one would be a Gene episode. Duh. Oh. I mean, I still don't remember much at all about this one, except for the fact that there's the other guy who's off somewhere, apparently, who's gonna enter the episode at some point. And it's, you know, this is the race war metaphor. This is how they talked about racism in the 60s. And how it got past censors in the 60s. I mean, Majel Barrett really wasn't kidding when she said that Gene Roddenberry, in order to talk about the stuff we wanted to talk about, just needed to, like, paint someone purple, call them a Martian, and that's all it took to get past censors back in the day. Because we were less sophisticated, both as storytellers and as an audience. Now, much harder. But also at the same point, now we can talk about a lot more things. Not enough, but a lot. I think it's body paint. I don't know about you guys. Right, give him a second to bust out his tools, you know. But yeah, Federation. Lokai? Ooh, Uncharted. Well, if it's Uncharted, how do you got a name? Would you bar... Monotone humans. Interesting. I wonder how they got such a perfect line down the center. Cause like that's a pretty perfect line across over a bumpy surface. Like look at how good, like really, A plus to the makeup department. Also, I love the detail that they gave him white, not fucking eyeshadow, mascara. They gave him white mascara for the white side and black, like they. What, is there just like a second shuttle with the other guy? Literally. Cloaking device? Is he in something Romulan? That explains why we can't see it. I must say, Chekhov's hair definitely got better in season three. Which is funny because Kirk's hair got worse. Which is even funnier because you think we'd get better at wigs like Shatner needed, but we got worse throughout the 50s and 60s. He had really great hair pieces. And then the 70s came along, and it's like we forgot how to. I don't know. I don't know. That is some A-plus red alert camera work right there. I don't feel anything. Nothing? Ah. That guy looks vaguely familiar under the makeup. Has he been on the show before? Is he one of the people that they reused? Right? What the heck were you on? What was your vehicle? No kidding. What kind of special materials was that? And your beef with him is. Okay. Oh my God. This aired in 1969. We're talking like height of the civil rights movement. And that whole debate was an exact replication of like every single core like struggle, core debate, core maddening bullshit of the civil rights movement, and just of, because it's depressing how it's that exact scene is perfectly perfectly transferable to the arguments that we're having today for equality on both racial and obviously sexuality and like all fronts, right? Oh my God. Holy shit. And the censors really were like, well, these are aliens talking about alien problems. Fuck. That might be my favorite shot of this entire episode. Just the... I love it. I love it so much. Oh, no. You don't say. Your will can drive it right up your ass. Your last battlefield. Break you in half. Ooh, we're playing with the big guns now. Corbin might maneuver 3.0. Work faster! Very futuristic computing sounds, by the way. I don't think the extreme close-ups are necessary. Bluffing Kirk or playing Chicken Kirk, or you know, we know what this is. Might be one of the hottest Kirks. I'm not gonna lie. It's a little warm in here. Well, we can't exactly kill him as much as we'd like to. he gonna try to pull now? And that's how you fucking do that. I was about to say, if we could turn off the... Oh, wow. Oh, wow. What an interesting way to parallel the struggle of trying to gather allies, because you're trying to explain it to people who are privileged. That's such a great way to... Wow. Wow. Ha 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 ha. I do remember this. Literally the only thing I remembered about this episode. I'm just over here with my water. Well, yeah, we. Yeah. Scotty's getting a little salt and pepper going on. Allergies and I'm just so fucking generally impressed with the unbelievable way that they're handling this. It's not exactly kind of the way it should be, but it's overwhelmingly close. It depends on what the last 10 minutes does. I am so fucking amazed that this happened in 1969. I think one of the things is that it's not an exact parallel, is that there are a couple of very important distinguishing factors from this specific fictional context and civil rights. So in a very yay 60s fashion. Right? Can we just airlock this guy? I mean, I realize that goes against all the principles of this current flock of humans. But, like, please. Sabotage? Was that the Canadian coming through? They already have them penned into communities. Thank you. Oh, yeah. But also, so sort of par for the course in that they get so close to the finish line and then fumble one of, not all, but one of the core messages of the episode. Because when it's a matter of oppressor and oppressed telling both sides that they just need to stop hating is not, that's missing the point. Both sides don't need to stop hating. The oppressor needs to fucking stop oppressing. There are so many other aspects of this episode that are really fucking impressive, especially for 1969. But this is a common pitfall when a predominantly white show and showrunners and writers and everything try to tackle race. They usually end up somewhere here. This might be the funniest sequence I've ever seen on this show. One of them. Let's be real. Where are you going? So they're both going to wind up down on the planet to just fight each other until one or both of them dies. Yep. No, it really doesn't. Once again, when it comes to white people trying to discuss race, I am disappointed but not surprised. Like I said before, this is usually where people trying to be progressive, this is usually where white people end up about race. Someplace that somehow just misses the mark, but then also massively misses the mark at the end, even when their intentions are good. And they make some really good points. This happens so often. And it's interesting to see that it's been happening since literally 1969. I, of course, am not the ultimate authority to talk about how effective and or how ineffective, how informed, how misinformed this episode is, obviously. But if there is a person of color watching this, I would love to hear your take on this episode. I would love to get as many people as possible to weigh in on exactly, just on exactly. That's it for this episode. Thank you so much for watching. I will be back very soon with the last episode in the entire series, Turnabout Intruder. And please remember to take care of yourself.